Are you thinking about launching a new website this year? Well, we need to take a big step back and talk about how do you launch a website without losing SEO? We're going to deep dive into this topic and make sure that you continue to move up in the search ranking and not start all over. All right, so let's talk about website launches from the trenches. So I have been doing this forever, as my son lovingly says, since the dinosaurs walked the earth. Thanks, honey. Love you too. Anyway, I have been doing this a long time. I started building websites in 1998. So I was pretty much at the front of that wave, and I've pretty much been riding it ever since. It's a wonderful business. I just love what I do. But unfortunately, the other side of my business is I get to see a lot of mistakes. A lot of people scratch their head like, what do we do? What do we do wrong? One of the biggest ones is when you launch your website, it's so critical that you understand that you have built up a history, a legacy with Google. It's seen how many times you've launched a new site. It knows how much content you've created over time. And you've built up a certain legacy or SEO history. Some people call it juice, right? You've built up this reputation, if you will, with Google. Now, here's the rye. Is when you go to launch a website, how do you do that without losing all of that juice, all that historical credibility with the Googlebot? So I have a essential website launch checklist. Click the link below and you're gonna be able to download that checklist. It is a culmination of a decade of mistakes that I have seen clients make when they launch websites. I always like the expression, it only took me a decade to be an overnight success. This is not just like coming to me all of a sudden. This is really something that I have compiled, and I want you to have it because I've seen too many business owners kill themselves over websites, spend tons of money, and literally kill all of their SEO in one fell swoop. So let's talk about some of the biggest mistakes that people make with launching websites. So you've got a whole network of pages on your site now. What makes me cringe is when I talked to a website owner and they said, oh my gosh, we're so excited. We just launched our new website and we simplified. We made it easier. We made it less cluttered. Now, think about this. You are a Stanford professor in Google's eyes, in your topic. Now you launch this new website, you get rid of everything you've had historically and you launch a brand new baby website. And you have not made any association to all the old pages that were on the old site. So what's critical is that you have a document that has all of your old URLs, and then you have a document that has all your new URLs. Now your job is to marry them, to dovetail them together, so that when you launch your new website, all of these links don't just poof, disappear, and you're starting from ground zero again. You don't want to do that. I mean, I have had companies come to me after my programs, and they say, we just spent $110,000 on an unfindable website. We deleted 250 blogs that we didn't think we needed anymore. Think about it, that could be 250 backlinks from highly ranking keyword phrases. I don't care how old the blogs are, they're part of your lexicon, right? They're part of your knowledge base. You don't want to get rid of that. So remember, when you're working with web developers, do not assume that they know what to do when you launch. They know how to build a website. It doesn't mean they're SEO experts and understand that dovetailing. Okay, this is a fancy word, and I'm sorry for the nerd moment, but it's called an HT access redirect. HT access redirect or permanent redirect document. This must be put on the website before you flip the switch. Now, everyone's going to be super excited to launch that new website. You've worked hard. I get it. You want that puppy to go live, but you've got to make sure that you have your pre-launch checklist, which is what the link is on this video. You're gonna be able to download that pre-launch checklist. I want you to sit down with your web developer, and I don't care how much they roll their eyes, just do it, and go through every single component. There are probably over 40 things that you need to address before you launch a new website. I'm gonna give you the cliff notes to launching a website. The first one is going to be make sure that you're on a secured server. So I don't know if you guys have seen it. When you look at a website page, you'll see HTTPS right at the top. Now, not all websites are HTTPS, some of them are just HTTP. Now, Google has ratcheted down the importance of a secured domain and a secured host because WordPress, a lot of you maybe have heard of WordPress, you have a WordPress site, they have a lot of security issues. They get hacked a lot. So they want to make sure that the security is solid on your website. So make sure that before you launch your new website, you give your hosting company a call or someone in your web development team calls and moves you to a secured server with a dedicated IP address. Hosting companies sell IPs in something called an IP block. So think of it like a cul-de-sac. When you move into a cul-de-sac, you really don't know your neighbors. And then right after you move in, they put the couches on the front porch and they have the truck rally every Saturday. So think about when you buy a hosting account, you're sharing in a cul-de-sac. And sharing is not caring here, okay? You want to make sure that you call your host and you say, I need a dedicated IP. I ain't sharing. So dedicated IP, secured server. And finally, let's talk domain names for a minute. When you're looking at your domain name, go in and take a look at when it expires. So if you have 6 months on your expiration date for your domain, what would you think about that? Would you think maybe are they going away in 6 months? Are they coming back? I don't know what they're going to do. So Google's going to kind of put you in like a sandbox and say, I'll wait until you renew that domain before I'm really going to give you the juice that you need. Make sure that you go in by at least 2 years on your domain, just so there's no misunderstanding that you're not going anywhere. Then the next thing on your domain name is by the .net, the .com, and the .org. So important. I have this on the checklist as well, because that's a suite of domain names. Do not, I beg you, do not buy any other extensions. I don't care if it's like .bananas and you sell bananas. Don't buy .bananas. Don't buy .fish. Don't buy .expert, .speaker, .concrete. These domain extensions are a scam. The domain companies like GoDaddy and some of these bigger guys, they create false urgency around these domains. There are still a ton of .coms available, I promise. I'm amazed at how many .coms are still available on the market. But don't buy .expert or .pizza or whatever, because they don't rank in Google. Go ahead and take a look. If you look down all the search results, there are no .pizzas, no .bananas, even if you're searching for bananas, okay? So keep in mind, if you're gonna sell the business at some point, a sellable asset is gonna be the .com, the .net, and the .org. Download the pre-launch checklist. That link is on the video here. And I wanna make sure that you protect yourself, because you don't wanna start from scratch. You've built up a great reputation. You have a fantastic business. I don't want us to drop the ball in the end zone before you launch your new site. I want to keep going up and to the right. Make sure to follow me, and I will give you great videos every day. I'm a geek. I love geeking out about SEO and findability. Make sure to hit subscribe. Hit the bell that's right next to that so you get notified every time I launch a new video, and we can geek out together. See you next time.